Dear Journal, oh, what a great day to be woken up by birds. It appears that I have made a new friend right here at my front porch. My own personal early bird to help me welcome the new day. And with a new day comes a brand new adventure unlike any other that we had so far. We'll be heading into the jungles of the great beyond, as well as have our own childhood dreams come true. This is going to be a day to remember.
All right, you start.
Everybody, this is you. Come on.
Just start.
Wait a minute. Miss Simpson was not a part of our National Geographic.
I remember Miss Simpson doesn't know it.
Come on.
But what's the other part?
I don't know.
We don't know.
After traveling across Lewa for some time, we then came across, you guessed it, another herd of elephants. This one was led by a tuskless matriarch who seemed very cautious of us being there. I was surprised to learn that even elephants without tusks can be the highest ranking in a herd. Dominance and authority are the keys to being a matriarch. She came in rather close, and I really thought for sure that she might interact with us. But instead, she then meandered around us, as well as the rest of the herd. She didn't seem to care much that we were there, though she did seem rather annoyed that we were in her way. Regardless, another awesome elephant encounter to remember. Then took a journey into the Ngare Ndare Forest. As the savannah slowly transitioned into thick jungle, the amount of plants hitting our truck was steadily increasing, but we pushed through no matter what, going across rocky terrains and streams and uphills, downhills. It was a very treacherous journey, but a very adventurous one at that.
Alright, so now we have gone deep into the forest, and there are a ton of flies, and and we saw the monkeys earlier.
And baboons,
which is also a monkey, I think.
Yeah.
we pushed forward into the forest, the amount of insects and arachnids steadily increased. Knowing myself having a phobia of arachnids and insects, I bared with it for as long as possible. And it was actually not that bad. The insects appeared to be leaving us alone for the most part. Until I actually saw one at the corner of my eye sitting on my shoulder.
Freaking fly. What?
And then there seemed to be a spider stuck on the canopy of the rover.
What's that?
Just say, don't look that way.
Don't look that way. Come on, man.
We then finally came to the stop at the end of the road, where we then left the safety of our rovers and continued our journey through the forest on foot. As we made our way through the thick shrubberies, our guide stopped us here and there along the way to show us special herbs that could be used as various remedies.
You know, like the warriors, they use them as a bendland, right? Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah, they put them on the armpit for when they go for the festivals. Yeah, yeah, we call it the world basil. That's what everyone smells.
Like a natural deodorant.
Yeah, natural deodorant.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's amazing how many medicinal and useful plants there are skewed about this forest, as well as creatures, both beautiful and not so beautiful.
Is that a crab spider?
No, we call it the kite spider.
Where? Can you see?
Yeah, right here. That's a kite spider. Can you see the web?
Uh-huh.
We don't have any poison. See, we call them the cow spider or the kite spider. We don't have like the big one, the baboon spider. Mm-hmm.
Oh, goodness. That's...
You can see the web. And they use their hind legs to make to put the web.
Wow. That's freaky. Jungle trek. Quite a slope.
Yeah, quite a slope, but you have steps slowly. After a steep and treacherous descent down a hillside, we made it to a beautiful looking waterfall. A great place to take photos and just admire the beauty of nature itself.
At the what falls?
Ngare
Ndare Falls. Ngare Falls. Doing good, Scott.
Put that camera away.
How was that?
It was good.
So now we are going to go to the swimming hole, which is down these steps. Here comes everybody else. Everybody's doing a side shuffle.
We then headed down another steep slope to another cascade of water, this time a deep pool you can actually jump in. There were various rock outcroppings that would give us a variety of levels to jump from. I was too nervous myself to try this out, but Caitlin, Lexi, Amy, and one of our guides gave it a go.
Wow. You're gonna do it all the way from up there? Wow.
Quite a beautiful water hole, beautiful waterfall, but I chicken out on this one as well. I don't know, it just seems kind of high up the jump. Maybe next time I'll try. Yeah.
We're sliding. So now we are going up into the trees. Basically we are going to be in the canopies, like 50 to 60 feet up. Being that I'm slightly afraid of heights, that's not exactly a good thing, but I'm
30 feet up.
Okay, I'm over exaggerating. But we're gonna be walking on this kind of netted thing that sways around.
You gotta let one person go like 15 feet before the next one.
Really? Oh crap. I think I can do it. Okay, I think we're good. Oh god, this is more terrifying than I thought.
A canopy walk, as they call it. A cable-netted bridge about 35 feet up entwined within the branches of a grove of trees. It was quite scary, for the netted bridge swayed every time I took a step across, as well as reverberating with everyone else's footsteps.
Oh, alright. Oh, there's an elephant skull down there.
A little later, I began to become used to the feel of the bridge itself. I can't say the same for the others, though. They seem quite terrified.
Are you guys enjoying yourselves? Are you enjoying yourselves? Oh. How did they do that? Huh. They put a tree right in the middle of this thing. Who put this tree here? Yeah, it's not as, once you get used to it, it's not that bad. It's actually very scenic up here. I wonder if we'll see elephants roaming. Oh man. We are really high up here. Oh yeah, this scenery is really beautiful.
Yeah.
What?
Do you know the Lion King words?
What, the whole script?
The circle of life.
It's Ingunyama Nengwenemabada. That's not it, no.
Oh, look, our trucks.
Oh.
Hey, yeah.
It's not pink pajamas, penguins on the bottom.
Penguin and a llama.
No, it's not. It's Zulu for... If you actually research it, you'll know.
Lunch is ready, self-service.
Oh, great.
Wash your
hands first. Wow. I'm gonna go up on this thing again just to see if I could see any birds. So. Oh, there's Patty. As I said before, You have not lived till you have come to Africa and do this sort of thing with being up in the canopies, up in the trees with the tarakos. It's just freaking amazing. And scary at the same time. Oh, goodness.
After lunch, we then pushed our way out of the forest and headed to Barana Conservancy.
Barana.
Barana cattle?
There's a type of cattle called Barana, and also a community called Barana.
Where we saw the hilly landscape in all of its glory, as well as its beautiful animals. There was something even more amazing about this place than just the land itself. Barana Conservancy is also home to the real Pride Rock. Yes, it does exist. When I first laid eyes on it, I almost broke into tears. It was just so beautiful sitting there right on the side of a large rocky valley. The view was absolutely spectacular. The way it just juts off from the hill itself makes it such a prominent feature to the great lands of Africa.
Where the Disney animators stayed at when they were getting inspiration to make the movie The Lion King. Unbelievable. It's unbelievable, isn't it, that 22 years ago, they were, or maybe even more before that, they were discussing the script and the look of the movie itself. So this is the view that they got. That's the view that they got, that they had when they were staying here. Wow. It's unbelievable. Listen to that wind. Can you believe it? This is where they were. 23 or 24 years ago, this is where they were staying to get inspiration for the movie itself. It's unbelievable. Well, it looks shut down right now, but it's still pretty. Wow. I just can't believe the views they had from here. It's beautiful.
After checking out the lodge, we then began our ascent to the top of Pride Rock. Yes, we were actually able to climb all the way to the top to get the lay of the land. I've never felt so excited in my entire life. I've been dreaming of doing this since childhood, and now it is about to come true. Possibly one of the greatest moments in our entire lives. We all stood on the real Pride Rock for the very first time. It was absolutely magical, to say the least. Watching the movie as a kid and wanting to visit Africa and Pride Rock ever since really makes this moment all the more memorable and worthwhile. The inner child in all of us was really screaming with joy at this very moment in time. I could barely contain myself. Caitlin was almost crying tears of joy. I can see how the animators from Disney took reference from this very scenery. The similarity to the movie itself is striking. I never want to leave this beautiful place.
We're on Pride Rock. After that exhilarating experience, we head back to the trucks. But I will never forget the memories of being on top of that big giant rock that the Disney animator is based off of for the movie The Lion King, as you probably already know. Isn't that great, Daniel?
That's so great, yeah.
Oh, man.
That's a good thing, man.
I could safely say that I have officially lived, and I don't know what else that occurs in my future life can top that. Besides coming back again to
Africa,
and seeing all this beautiful landscape, and oh man. But yeah, I think we all of us have officially lived. Ooh, oh, got to get some good rock climbing here.
There's a hippopotamus behind us.
Hippopotamus rhombotomus. Yeah. Thank you.
We have lived.
Yes, we have. Hemingway, you have been to Pride Rock and back.
Yes.
The saga continues.
The saga continues.
The saga continues.
Hakuna Matata. Birdie.